Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains. In this video, we're going to work on the river part of my layout and make a real easy barge. Okay, the materials, a piece of basic sheet styrene, V-groove sheet styrene, 0.125 by 0.125 strip styrene, a scale ruler, a straight edge ruler, and glue, sharp X-Acto knife, that type of stuff. Okay, now I wanted this barge to be 35 scale feet. If you don't have a scale ruler, that comes out to 2 5/8 of an inch. 2 5/8 inches. Now most barges, I think, are like 195 feet. Mine's going to be 159 scale feet or 12 inches long. Now when I had my sheet, I think that was 13 inches long, so I had to cut an inch off of it. So once again, 1 foot long equaled 159 scale feet. Now this is the top part of the barge. So what I did is I used my rulers and measured out what I thought would be good for the top. The front is going to be bigger for walking, for the guys to actually tow the barges together. The sides and the back are relatively narrow. So once I had it all drawn out, then I used my sharp X-Acto blade and patiently, and that's what you really need when doing this, is patience. I just kept making passes until it finally, you know, was able to cut all the way through the styrene. Didn't want to bend it and break it that way because I wanted to keep this as one whole piece. So once I had that all cut out, I put it aside and I started to work on the sides. That's where the V-groove siding comes in. With the V-groove siding, make sure you get the right size. I used every second line, and I just added another couple passes with the X-Acto blade, and then I broke it off. But notice that, you know, I don't have to do any measuring because it's all going to be uniform. You'll need three of these. You'll use two for the sides, and then that extra piece will for the back. Now this is a rake style barge, which means the front is going to be angled to cut through the water better. These are always the first barges. And so I just kind of guessed at what I wanted as an angle. And then I took another one and I turned it the opposite way. And I used the first one as a guide. And I made the two sides, and they're even. The lines, the V-groove part, since it's only on one side, that'll be facing the inside, so you won't be able to tell. Okay, so now I have two even sides, and I want to glue them onto the top part. And what I'm going to use, I always use bracing. That's why I have the 0.125 strip styrene. Brace everything when you're working with styrene. The strip, I made it just a little bit shorter than the frame. And then once I thought it had a good size, I went over and just simply made a second one, using the first one as a guide on how big to make it. And then just using that liquid glue, I glued it all together. The top, the side, and the bracing, the strip for the bracing. To me, it's so much easier than working with wood, especially because the drying time when using white glue. I love the fact that this goes together really easy. I used that third piece to make the back. And I braced that with just small pieces. Cut a piece of strip for the bracing for the front. And going back to that sheet styrene, the black, I think that was 0.030. Not 100% sure. I think that's what it was. And I cut a piece for the front and then had to have a piece for what's known as the rake side. That's the angle side that makes contact with the water first. Okay, so I just made sure I had enough glue and every possible angle I could to make sure that it was totally secure. Next, I'm going to go back to the V-groove siding and I'm going to cut single strips. I need three of the single strips. And this is going to be for the inside part of the barge. I'm not going to use the strips styrene for bracing. As long as I cut this to a perfect, you know, rectangle, It's fine. It's actually was came up pretty strong. So I'm really liking the way this looks, but of course, being an N scale, we know that they don't have the details that we always want that the HO guys have. But I wanted to make the post that the sailors wrap the ropes around to tie the barges together. So I had to make it myself. And what I did, I just simply got some piping that I had laying around, and I cut into 8 real small pieces, and then I just made like a top to go over top of it, and that was just from a little strip of sheet styrene. Glued it all together, I made 8 of these to go around, and I mean, it's a small detail, and whenever it's painted, it's going to look pretty good. So just kind of give you an example of what I made. 2 up front, 2 in the back, and then 2 on the sides. It's a small detail, but if you see these at N scale, let me know. In the meantime, we have to kind of, you know, improvise and make them ourselves. Okay, the next thing I wanted was the base. And so I put it on the sheet, traced it out with a pencil, and then cut it out. I glued it all together, but I forgot to take video of it, and it was time for paint. Okay, now look at this 2 types of paint that I use. It is Rust-Oleum Flat Black Automotive Primer and Krylon Ruddy Brown. You mix the two together. When I say mix it together, it's like you hit it with some black, then hit it with brown. Back, forth, and the result is fantastic. You ready? Bam! Here it is. Hey, how kick-ass is that? That is the look of mixing the 2 colors together. And I'm going to go over it a little later on with some chalks and weather it a little bit more. But that gives you that realistic steel. So this is a really inexpensive barge. I hope you like it. We're going to be doing a lot more to this river. And hey, I'll show you something. I tried making one of these like a long time ago, and I made it too small. But for the loads to go in, you know what the best thing to use is simple styrofoam. And here's what I mean. This is an old one that I had, and I just had styrofoam, and I carved it to look like coal. It's so light. It's so not messy. It's been taking a beating. But yeah, you just paint it black. You know, just shape it nice, and it goes right in there. So I'm probably going to end up making a bigger one for the new barge. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my channel under DJ's Trains. I'm the only one under DJ's Trains. I've seen someone else they stole my video, try to upload it as their own, got it shut down. But if you don't see DJ's Trains, don't subscribe. Check out my webpage, www.djstrains.com, and email me at djstrains@yahoo.com. I'm probably not going to get another video till sometime in January because the garage is so cold and work is really busy. Leave me ideas on what you want to see in future videos. Got more work on the river. We pour in the water pretty soon and doing more river details. So thanks a lot, guys. I appreciate all the new subscribers. Have a great holiday. Bye-bye. It's cold in there.